Hey guys, Dominic with Wholesale ATV again. I was going to give you guys a quick rundown of the adult go-karts. They're all pretty much the same in the maintenance department. Everything I'm going to show you is going to be pretty much the same on any models that you don't see on our floor plan right now. Right now I'm showing you is the 170 models, and everything that we've got here is a 170 model. I'll give you a quick rundown on this one. It's very similar to the youth go-karts and the whole starting procedure. You're going to put the key in the ignition switch right here, hold the brake down, turn the key to start it. Like all the other ones, this one takes 93 or non-ethanol fuel it will run the best on. The oil change is going to be 1040 ATV oil, and you're going to have to change the oil after you go through a first tank because it does have break-in oil in it. Okay, so gas goes in here, and your oil dipstick is right in here. I know it's probably difficult to see, but there's your dipstick. And on the dipstick, it's going to show you the level of low or full. And the drain plug is right up under the case. And it's going to be a 17 millimeter bolt right there. So what you're going to want to do is just break the bolt loose, let the oil fall out. There's a screen on top of that drain plug. You're going to clean the screen off. That is virtually your filter. Put the drain plug back in after all the oil has come out, and then fill right here. And it's roughly going to take about a quart of oil, not too much more than that. Battery is on the left-hand side on this one, and I've talked about the fuse box a few times through these different videos, and just letting you know yet again, this fuse is in here. If you don't see anything come up on the dash and it won't even try to start over, that fuse is blown. It's very simple to open that box up, take a fuse that's in there, take it out, and put a new one in. There's already a new one waiting for you in there. I'm going to remind you again about the battery chargers. You're going to want to charge this battery up every now and then. You know, it can go dead. What you're going to want to use is a Shoemaker battery maintainer. We have that link on our website, and it has an auto kill function on that, which means that when the battery is fully charged, it turns off and it stops charging the battery, so it doesn't
kill. I wanted to also tell you about the choke process on this. This is an auto choke, so you don't have to worry about if it's cold trying to pull the choke and making it start. No, this has an auto choke on it. So turn the key, give it a little bit of gas while you're trying to start it, and it will start up an auto choke for you. Also wanted to show you the turn signal features on here. Sort of like the scooters, you just turn it to the desired turn that you want to do, and then press it in to kill the turn signal so it stops turning, blinking. You have a shifter right here, which is neutral in the middle, drive in front, and reverse in rear. Emergency brake. Pretty much it about that, except for the oil. Now, like on all our other units that we have, you're going to want to change the oil after the first tank.
This is another go-kart we have. This is the 200 GKM2. This one is very similar in the last go-kart and all the other go-karts we show you. You have a kill switch, run switch right here. Your ignition switch is there. Key, turn it to the right while holding the brake to start. Your shifter is down there in the center, and you have a drive, neutral, and reverse feature. Middle is going to be neutral, drive forward, reverse rear, and your emergency brake there. You have the same, pretty much you're going to want to run 93 octane fuel or non-ethanol, and it also has the auto choke feature. Hey guys, Dominic again, Wholesale ATV, and I wanted to show you the GKA, the GKF, and the GKR. Now a lot of people ask, what's the difference between these GKF, GKA, and GKR models? The only difference in these models are the plastics. That's the only difference. So they have everything is pretty much exactly the same. Operation and maintenance on it is exactly the same. The only difference you're getting is different plastics. Okay, so give a quick rundown. You got your gas tank here, 93 or non-ethanol. It has these two clamps here to help get to it, because I can lift that on up. You can get on into that gas tank. Your carburetor and everything is up on top. Your drain plug is right up under the case. And your dipstick is right here for putting oil in it. Like everything else we have, this comes with break-in oil, and you're going to have to change the oil after the first gas tank has been gone through. Starting it is like the others. Put the key in the ignition switch, hold the brake and turn the key, and it will start up for you. These are your light switch, lights on and light off, low beam, high beam, and turn signals. I also wanted to show you guys something else about these go-karts that'll come in handy for you. Alright, so you have a speed limiter. That means that these will go a good 30 plus miles an hour, and if you don't feel comfortable with that,
there is a screw behind here, behind the throttle, gas pedal. If you back that screw out, it'll block the pedal so it can't be pushed all the way down, and you can set what speed you want. Oh, and then the adjustable seats. There's also an adjustable seat option. Now, this seat does not move, but this one does. So you got a lever underneath the seat, push it forward, and push it backwards. E-brake is in the center as well.
So that concludes our adult go-kart session. If you guys have any questions or concerns, you can give us a call at the service department. I'd be more than happy to help you guys out.